Fokker Dr.1 Triplane.
Now this is known as the famous Red Baron Triplane during the time of the Great War. Notice the ailerons as the plane taxis out of a triplane, that they extend beyond the wing itself a little bit. That shows some design parameters that they were experimenting with in its day for aileron usage and roll and pitch and all kinds of design parameters. What, about a 6-foot takeoff run on that plane, huh? Five, I was corrected.
He can go in three.
If the wind is right. Scale. It too is built on a lot of wood, typically, with very few metal fittings, only in the critical areas that they would use metal fittings. And then obviously a linen type of material that would be covered and stretched and shrank, and then they would use paint, what they call dope, during its day to dope up the plane and color it.
I'm sorry, did landing gears even held on with copper wire?
Now. Oh, that triplane is using a Zenoma 26 engine. It too is a nice engine. Planes and the horsepower of the engines. Very crude in its day, but that's all they had for design criteria. Also, they used for lubricant quite often was castor oil in the engines. And likewise, we use castor oil in our model engines today, too, which is a very good lubricant to lube the engines with, because it's very forgiving for lubrication and also in temperature applications. Here's where it gets a little tricky. Fortunately, the wind is, it's quartering a little bit, but not bad. Wings are nice and level, he's not bumping too hard. Looks like it's gonna come down nice and easy. Yeah, there you go. Nice flight, nice flight.
Very nice.